First, let's talk about the structure of the English language. Vowels and consonants make up alphabets. Alphabets make up words. Words, with the help of syntax, make up sentences. And sentences make up paragraphs and so on. So from this, can't we say that English is structure? It is so predefined. How can we call it loose?
I would like to clarify, which English are we going to speak in today? British English, American English, or Indian English? I mean, this itself tells us that English is a very loose and vague language. I mean, every day there are 14.7 words introduced to the English language. It's not really possible to master English.
English is so loose that the placement of words in the sentence alone can completely change its meaning. It is so flexible that certain great minds can even create and imbibe in the language completely new phrases, structures, and words. And for an example, why look further than William Shakespeare's works?
How rigid can a language be if you can integrate your own mother tongue in it and term it English or Kunglish?
First of all, what is the purpose of language? The main purpose of language is communication. Communication is the key. If I want to express myself, if I want to deliver a message to you, it is through the English language that I do it. But why English? Because it's a structured language.
When we have to transfer our messages, others understand us. How are they doing this? It's because English is structured. If it was loose, how can we be understood? That's why we use English to reach out to the masses in communication.
From Shakespearean English to our present-day slang English. From how fare thee to, hey buddy, what's up? English is constantly evolving. It's always changing. There's nothing, you know, there's no hard and fast rules for English.
English language, which is spread all over the world, which is spoken in most of the countries. That's a fact which all of us knows. But it doesn't unite the country.
The system of vowels and their pronunciation differs with every dialect and with every combination of letters.
Take the example of the combination of letters O-U-G-H. As given in the pronunciation dictionary, in cough, we pronounce it as off. In toe, it's O. In through, it's O. Similarly, there are 5 more pronunciations of O-U-G-H.
So, how will someone know which one to use if O-U-G-H comes in a word? Pronunciation also differs with every dialect.
An Aussie would say, I'm here to speak to Ty. You hear it as he's here to speak to die. But what he actually means that he's here to speak today. Every dialect pronounces words according to their regional influences, and these pronunciations are accepted by the dictionaries that maintain the language.
Evolution is necessary. How are we supposed to change? How are we supposed to progress? If not for evolution of the language, won't we be stuck in the 15th century, in the medieval ages? How will we have progress without evolution?
And about the words which are coming in day by day, they all are recognized universally. They are recognized by the globe and they are very well added. They are accommodated in the Oxford Dictionary. So this doesn't show that English is a loose language.
English is evolving, I admit it. But can we tell that English was created? Most of the words in English were not created. They were got away from other languages. For example, the word mother, which is commonly used in English. It was copied from the Sanskrit word matar, which is pronounced as M-A-T-R. They have stolen so many words from so many languages and created a language called as English.
In response to my friends from Team A, I'd like to say, just like you said, new words are included every day. Doesn't that show you that English is adaptable? It's loose. It includes new words. For example, we say, I'll Google it.
Well, all of us say we'll Google when we're going to search for information.
But isn't it only lately, perhaps in the last decade, that Googling it was introduced as an actual English phrase? Like this, tons of new words are introduced in English every year, showing how adaptable it is as a language.
Evolution is a must, as my partner had mentioned. If we don't evolve, then we'll be stuck in the medieval ages. We and our language have to evolve. That's a basic necessity which we must understand.
So me and my partner would like to conclude by saying that English is truly a loose language, influenced by various people around the world, contributing to its evolution because of its adaptability.